A river regime is the variability in a river's discharge throughout the year. This variability is the river's response to changes in precipitation, temperature, evapotranspiration, and drainage basin characteristics. In Southeast Asia, for example, you can expect that the discharge of its rivers would be higher in the wet season months of July and August, when precipitation is at its highest. Further, any snow melted from the Himalayas to the north would add more water to the streams and rivers of the region. Any sudden increase in the amount of water travelling down a river will cause flooding. This discharge of a river can be displayed on a graph called a flood hydrograph. This graph displays the amount of rainfall as a bar graph and the discharge of the river as a line graph. Flood hydrographs are useful in predicting how a river will behave during a time of intense rainfall. This is useful for local authorities who are in charge of planning flood prevention. Since most rainwater falls onto the land before making its way into rivers, there is a lag time between the time of peak rainfall and peak discharge. A flood hydrograph can be used to work out how quickly this occurs. Hydrographs in catchment areas with little vegetation and steep slopes will show the peak discharge rise quickly. Floods occur when a river bursts its bank and the water overflows onto the floodplain. Generally, flooding is caused by heavy rain. The faster the rainwater enters the river channel, the more likely it is going to flood. The following factors may further encourage flooding. Steep slopes surrounding a river channel cause rapid surface runoff. If there is little or lack of vegetation in the drainage basin, then surface runoff will be high. This is because plants and trees intercept precipitation. If a drainage basin has a geology of mainly impermeable rock, water will run faster over its surface into the channel. Human changes to the environment can also cause water to run off faster than before, such as in urban areas where impermeable concrete surfaces encourage rapid overland flow of water into drains and then into rivers. Water also runs quickly off the sloping roofs of houses. Floods can have both negative and positive impacts. On one hand, they can cause enormous damage to homes and people's belongings, as well as lead to the loss of life. Transport networks can be inundated, causing some communities to be cut off. Floods can also cause extra erosion, undermining roads and bridges. On the positive side, flooding deposits a fine fertile silt called alluvium onto the floodplain. This makes the soil fertile and suitable for agriculture. Since ancient times, people lived on or near floodplains to take advantage of the excellent conditions for farming. They have relied upon regular flooding to support their farming activities.